Welcome back to Kids Church. We've just finished our series on the biggest questions on earth, and we're starting our new series on the biggest dreamers.
Wow, we have some exciting things planned in this episode, like you're gonna see when Ollie prays, it changes the path of a cheetah.
Oh my goodness. And Rasha has set out a pretty crazy challenge for the Rath family. I sure hope they accept.
Me too. And we're going to hear from Mrs. Bunsen Burner and Professor Bobby Beaker that have a segment that's gonna rock.
Well, let's hand it over to the Rath family.
Hi kids, Rasha has challenged us to a game.
We accept. Today we are talking about faith.
The Bible says we walk by faith, not by sight.
Today we're going to navigate a tricky obstacle course. Roman will be blindfolded and I will be behind him, leading him through the course.
Abraham a vision to be a father of many nations. Just like Abraham, God has an exciting and wonderful plan for you.
Even though we may not be able to clearly see, he takes us step by step. We have his voice and the Holy Spirit to lead us.
God is always behind us, leading us on. We just need to listen carefully. He never leaves or forsakes us. Lift your hands up.
Let our hearts collide with yours. We can't help Wow, kids, don't you love praising God? Doesn't it stir your faith? Well, today we are learning all about faith. In fact, I'm looking here in the Bible at Hebrews 11, which talks about all these amazing people of faith. Do you remember learning about them? Let's see what it says. It says, faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being certain of what we do not see. That is what the people of long ago were praised for. And we have faith, so we understand that everything that was made when God commanded it. Do you remember learning about creation? That's why we believe that what we see was not made out of what can be seen. Gosh, God is amazing. Then we learn about Adam and Eve, and then Cain and Abel. In verse 3, it says Abel had faith, so he offered to God a better sacrifice than Cain did. Because of his faith, Abel was praised as a godly man. God said good things about his offering. Remember learning about him? And then we learn about Noah, didn't we? Well, there was also a man called Enoch. He had faith. Do you know that he didn't even die? Just suddenly, he just went straight to heaven. And they're like, where did Enoch go? Amazing. You read it for yourself. And then it carries on to talk about that without faith, it is impossible to please God. Those who came to God must believe that he exists and that he is a rewarder of those who seek him. Well, then we learned about Noah. Noah had faith, didn't he? And it carries on to talk about Abraham, and that is who we're talking about today.
So excited to see you kids today. Today we're going to be looking at Abraham in the Bible. Isn't that exciting? So let's take a look at it. The Lord said to Abraham, leave your country and your people. Leave your father's family. Go to the land I will show you. I will make you into a great nation. I will bless you. I will make your name great. Now Abraham was 75 years old when he left Haran. He took his wife Sarah and his nephew Lot. They took all the things they had. They set out for the land of Canaan. Wow! Imagine leaving your home country because God told you to go somewhere else. You know, interestingly enough, I left my home country to move to New Zealand. Yeah, that's right. For some of you guys who may know me, you know that I come from South Africa. And I moved to New Zealand when I was only 3.5 years old. But we didn't just move here because we wanted to. We actually moved because God told us to. He told my dad one night that we need to move to New Zealand. Imagine what a big shock it was. All of our family is still in South Africa. But honestly, I was a little bit excited because we got to go on a big aeroplane. Have you guys ever been on an aeroplane? It was so much fun. But what I didn't realize is that we were leaving all our grandparents and cousins and all these people behind. So I think once we actually moved to New Zealand, I missed them a little bit. And so guess what? We had to go back for a few months because Ishla and I missed our grandparents so much. But don't worry, it worked out fine. Because when we came back to New Zealand, yeah, we struggled a little bit learning and picking up the language, but God ultimately blessed us because it was his plan, not ours. So look at us now, all these years later, and we get to spend so much fun with you in Kids Church. Anyway, have a great day. See you later.
The Faithful Hall of Fame, Abraham. This is Abraham.
Hey.
When Abraham was younger, he was known as Abram.
Oh.
Abram lived in a place called Haran. One day, God told Abram, leave your home with your family and go to a place that I will show you.
Ah.
So Abram traveled with his wife Sarai, their nephew Lot, and the rest of their family. The new land that they made home was crowded. Abram said to Lot, let's not fight. Is the whole land not before us? Let's split up. You go one way and I will go the other way.
Aha!
So Lot looked to the left and to the right. He saw that the land of Jordan was well taken care of, so Lot chose to go the way that looked better to him. He took his family and they settled in the beautiful land near the town of Sodom. Abram took his family and they moved the other way. Then one day, God said to Abram, "Look up. All the land you see will be blessed. I will give it to you and your family forever." Abram received the promise and the blessing because he was faithful.
Thanks, Shanalise. What a great encouragement. Don't you love this amazing account of Abraham? These suitcases remind me of Abraham. He actually packed his bags and he headed off, and the Bible says that he didn't even know where he was heading. Let's see what it says in Hebrews 11. Abraham had faith, so he obeyed God. God called him to go to a place he would later receive as his own. So he went, and he did not even know where he was going. Because of his faith, he made his home in the land that God had promised him. He was like an outsider in a strange country. He lived there in tents. Would you like to live in a tent? He did. So did his Isaac and Jacob, and they received the same promise. Abraham was looking forward to the city that has foundations. He was waiting for the city that God planned and built. Abraham had faith. So he arrived and he was hanging on to that awesome promise, but he was even thinking about how God has an amazing place in heaven for him. He has an amazing place for you too. So as we were reminded, look at these suitcases, be reminded that we can be a people of faith too. God's going to ask you to do things and you might think, can I do that? What does that mean? But you've got to know that God is with you, and if he's given you a promise, he's going to help you fulfill whatever dream that he's placed in your heart to do.
I like to learn about rocks. They're really, really, really hot, burning underneath the earth's crust. Oh, well, hello, children. It's great to have you here. Bobby Beaker coming to you live on our field studio trip. We're going to be learning about rocks. It's going to be fantastic. Mrs. Bunsen Burner, I've started the camera already. We're ready to go to learn about rocks.
Oh, are you excited? Oh my God.
With our amazing Pastor Peter, our real father of faith. Today we're talking about Abraham. What are some things you like about Abraham?
Abraham, wow, what a man he is. He's in the Bible, right? Not only that, he is called the father of all who believe. So, you know, we are of the seed of Abraham. When you think about Jesus, he came through the seed of Abraham, through the genealogies of Abraham. And of course, you know, we're of that seed of Abraham as well. And when we're born again, born into the family of God, he was such a man of faith. He believed God, even when there seemingly be a hopeless situation. He was definitely a man of faith.
Did you have big dreams when you were a kid?
I did. Not as big as Abraham, though. I should have had bigger dreams, right? And I remember the story where God takes Abraham outside his tent and he says, look up at the stars and see all those stars? You're going to have as many children as them. Wow, that's a lot, right? That's a big vision. I didn't have that big a vision, but enough to say I did have some dreams as a kid. I had a dream like every kid wants to grow up and do something good with their lives, don't they? You know, become a nurse or a fire truck driver or something, you know? And so everybody has dreams, and I had dreams as a kid as well.
When's the time that you've needed big faith?
Well, when we first started City Impact Church back in 1982. That's a long time ago, right? I know that none of you were around, and not even your parents. Some of the parents weren't even born then, but in 1982. And I didn't really feel that I was kind of ready to start a church, but I knew God called me to start a church. And so I had to have faith. And faith is really stepping out on the word of God, believing God. That's what faith is. Faith is believing God, right? And so we started, and we started the church, and it was complete faith. I didn't know who was going to show up. I didn't know what was going to happen. But the first message that I ever preached, do you know what it was?
What?
Unless the Lord builds a house, we labor in vain. And that's really been what it's all about the Lord building his house. And we are just co-laborers, just like Abraham was a co-laborer with God.
What are some ways that I can grow my faith in God?
Well, obviously a couple of real good keys, and I think you may know already what they are. Read the Bible, because faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God, right? And so when we read the Bible and read the promises of God and read what God tells us in his word, our faith grows like a mustard seed. Jesus said it's like a mustard seed, and it grows in our life to become a big tree. And so we can read the Bible, we can pray the promises of God, speak the promises of God, right? And hang around people of faith too. Just like I'm hanging around you, because she is a woman of faith. And so, you know, hang around people of faith. Don't hang around with doubters. Don't hang around with people who are negative, who moan and groan and complain, you know, because that just rubs off on you, right? If you take a piece of coal, you know what a bit of coal is, right? And you put it in the fire, it begins to glow. If you take that bit of coal and take it out of the fire and put it on the hearth, it grows cold. Because it's all by itself. We've got to be around people who are on fire for God, who are passionate for Jesus, who are full of faith, right? And so when we hang around a good church like City Impact Church and City Impact Church Kids, Kids Online, when we hang around, we get our faith and it grows.
Thanks for watching Pastor Peter talk about faith.
Bye.
Bye.
Abraham left his country not knowing where he was going or what was going to happen to him. He had to put his trust in God and the dreams and visions that God gave him. When he did this, he was able to bless many people and even many generations after him. Praying is not just wishing for things to happen. Praying is actually speaking and believing God's promises, his word in the Bible. And when we speak out his word in faith, God hears us and he responds to us. Let's see what happened when our friend Ollie went to see his favorite animal at the zoo.
Here he comes, Ollie. Just what you said.
Whoa.
Just what you just asked.
Wow.
Hello. Just what you just asked.
Do
you know what that is?
Mate. That's insane. What was that like, Ollie?
He came right up to you, didn't he? And who did you ask for the cheetah to come up to you?
God?
Yeah, he just did a little prayer, like, please God, can you make the cheetahs come up to me?
Okay, yeah, you literally, like, you can't get any closer than that.
Mimi!
Here it comes again.
Literally. Wow.
How do you get down?
That's what happens when you pray to Jesus, eh? Good boy. Alright, we'll see what he does. Oh, he's turned around. He's done a 180 degree, and he is literally, wow, wow, that is, wow. Did you see him do a 180 degree turnaround and come right back to Ollie? We need to be like a child, man. We need to have that childlike faith. That is awesome. Man, God is good. I have never seen them. They can't get any closer.
Wow.
Hello. Ollie, what do you think? What do you say? What do you say to God?
Thank you.
What?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Wow, did you see what happened with the cheetah? How it walked past the window? God wants to hear your prayers. He's waiting for you, and He wants to listen, and He wants to answer your prayers.
Hey boys and girls, my name is Grace and today I'm sharing my testimony with you guys. I know that this week and last week you guys have been talking about Abraham and the story of Abraham, and I think that's so cool because the story of Abraham actually has a very special place in our family because it's something that the Lord has often spoken to us through with regards to us moving around quite a bit as well. And today I want to tell you all about how God has been in my life when we've moved from country to country to country. So, first of all, growing up, I have lived in a lot of places. I have lived in about 13 homes and gone to like 8 different schools and lived in 4 different countries. And it's been a big adventure. But it hasn't always been easy because, you know, you're leaving your friends and your family and your dogs and your puppies and everything that's familiar to you. And I remember when we first moved to New Zealand, I just missed my home so much. And I remember when we moved, the Lord actually asked me to leave my puppies behind. And I was so sad because I loved my puppy so much. I don't know if you have a puppy that you just love. Well, that was my puppy. And I put a picture of him on here. And I used to have photo shoots of him. And he was like the model. Every time I got my camera out, it's like he would pose for the photo. And I had to leave him behind and all my special friends. And it was so hard leaving them. Because, you know, when God asks you to move countries, it's like you have to give up everything and anything that is familiar to you. And New Zealand is so different to South Africa because none of my family's here, new friends, new scenery, new views, and so it was a big deal. But one of the best things I learned when we moved is that the worst thing you can do is get angry and stressed and worried and fight God's plan. The best thing to do is to trust Him and to see it as an adventure. So what I just wanted to remind you guys of and encourage you with is just like for Abraham and even for me, moving countries, whether it be once or 5 times, can be so pressurizing and so scary when we try and do it in our own strength and when we try and weigh up everything on our own. But when we just commit it all to God, in the Bible it says we must commit everything to the Lord and then we will live pleasantly in the land that He has given us. And so if you feel worried or nervous, the best thing that you can do is to see it as an adventure, to see it as an opportunity to learn something new and to surrender it to God. So you might not be asked by God to move countries, but for you it might be to go and greet a new friend or to give something up that you really love, whether it be your favorite chocolate bar that your brother really, really would love, or whatever it may be, to see it as an adventure, to trust God and to follow what He is calling you to do, because that's the best thing that you can do. What is faith? Faith is trusting and believing in what we don't see. So even though it might seem like a huge leap of faith, it's surely going to be an amazing adventure. Bye!
We have loved hanging out with you this week. I don't know if you've ever asked Jesus into your heart. Well, He wants to be your closest friend. All you've got to do is just talk to Him. Say, "Dear Jesus, I want you to be my closest friend. Please come into my life. Forgive me of my sins. I want to live for you. In Jesus' name, amen." It's as easy as that. He wants to take away our sins and He wants us to live a life for Him. Do you know, if you've said that for the first time, there's 3 great ways to build your faith. Number 1 is pray. Just talk to God. Just say, "Hey God, I'm having a good day, not so good. How are you today?" Just like you talk to a friend. Number 2 is read a Bible. If you don't have a Bible, get in touch because we would love to send one to you. And the 3rd one is find a great church. We'd love to have you at our church, but maybe we don't have a church near you. We would love to find a good church near you. These are awesome ways to build your faith. And let us know if you've done this at this email just here, kids@cityimpactchurch.com. Awesome, guys. What a great decision.
Wow, it is so important to find a great church, isn't it? Well, we've been talking all about dreams today. Have you ever had a cool dream, Tish?
Well, last year I was in the Christmas Spectacular and it was so much fun. I got to dance and sing and act with all my friends.
Wow.
Oh my goodness.
I did not know you could do that.
Oh, well.
Well, on that note, we have some epic footage from one of our shows here at City Impact Church. And it's all about dreams. Let's check it out.
I don't understand. You are Sergei, my cliche British butler. The old owner, you know, he was old Russian money. Before the SARS, they used to say.
Is that what they say, huh? You know what, Vladimir? The English accent is the easiest to replicate. But I must say it feels good to finally speak properly after all these years. Ah, Mother Russia, I love you. Vygotsya kharsho hadomo lucha.
What do you mean? You've been here the whole time. The whole time.
Yeah.
The whole time!
Oh, mi dile is muhe slona, Vladimir. I was waiting, watching you from the sidelines, and I thought I was never going to retire. But now I see. You've got your heart right, son. You listen to your daughter instead of listening to the money. And it's been a journey. But I think I'm ready to finally hand it over to you. You're going to do a great job, Vladimir. Yeah.
As much as I appreciate how much of an undercover boss revelation this is for me right now. You don't understand, sir. We're out of money. What good does this title deed do me now when I can't even afford to keep the place running?
Come on, Vladimir. I see you've already learned. Ni imesto ruble, I imesto druze. Besides, what good is old Russian money for anyway? I don't want all of it. You can have as much as you need.
Wow. But sir, why would you do this for us after all this time?
We give to what is most important to us, Vladimir. That's why God gave us his son at Christmas time. That's the message I've always wanted to share. And some things never stop being worth it. Some things you end up giving your whole life to. Now, all you people, listen up. You can keep your job. This is what I'm saying. You can continue to tell the world of the first Christmas. Continue to do what you do best. And remember,
Nigatani Univai!
Which means,
never lose the heart!